Welcome to the ET-335 Divide By In Counter Presentation. Hello, this is the lecture on divide by in counters. We've gone from our binary counters, and what we want to do is we want to decode out to different numbers besides the basic 2, 4, 8, and 16. Okay, this is an asynchronous counter. Okay. As it stands, without the decoder, it is a divide by 8. 2, 4, 8. Okay, and what we do on these is we add a decoder. In this case, it's going to be an AND gate. So we're going to provide a 1. This is going to just send a signal out. Okay, when this guy reaches 6. And the way we read that is this guy's talked to the queue, so he's going to be a 1, QB 1. Since this one's tied to the queue, not A, we're going to count that as a 0. And we need, this is the least significant digit, smallest. This is the most significant digit, the largest. Okay, and we're going to need to turn this number around. So we have 1, 1, 0. 110, which is going to be 6 base 10. So when this guy hits 6, we're going to send out a signal. It's going to be a high based on this AND gate. This is a 3-bit synchronous counter set up for mod 8. Mod 8 means divide by 8 is going to count from 0 to 7. Okay, so we have the clock here into this, and this is a standard mod 8, divide by 8, and the decoder here just allows us to decode this out so it works, being a 3-bit synchronous. We're going to use the asynchronous because they're easier to use. They do have the ripple effect, which is not such a big problem. Okay, this is an asynchronous decade counter, mod 10. Divide by 10 counts from 0 to 9. It's based on an asynchronous. Okay, divide by 16, 2, 4, 8, 16. We have to have more dividers than we have the modulus. We need to have that so we could divide it out. This is using a decoder based on a NAND gate. This NAND gate, once these two go high, is going to send a low, which is going to clear this. This is going to send a glitch out. It's going to go to the clear, and this guy was just going high. This guy was already high, so we're going to get a glitch. And we could see this. Here's our clear signal, so it takes a little time to do it. And we could look at this with a scope if we focus in a little bit on that small section. Okay, that's a glitch. That's where it resets. Okay, so we need to count this. This is a 1, 0, 1, 0. Okay, so this guy's going to decode out when these two guns go high. It's going to send this clear signal out. So if we do the counting, least significant digits A. Okay, so we're going to have 1, 0, 0, 1, which is a 9. So it's going to reset at 9, and it's going to count a 0 to 9. This is a working divide by counter. It's based on an asynchronous divide by 16, and what we're going to do is we're going to analyze this based on this decoder. We have a 0 coming out of here, which is going to be needed for our reset. This guy is a NAND gate. It's unique conditions 1 and 1. It's tied to the top, the Q, and it's going to be a 1. Okay, this guy needs a 1. This is a NOR gate. Unique condition 0, 0 equals 1 in order to get it to work. This is tied to the Q naught, which is a 0, which makes Q a 1. Okay, this guy is a NAND gate, 1, 1 equals 0, which is unique condition, which gets this one to work, which makes, it's tied to Q, which makes that a 1. This is tied to the Q naught, which makes the top a zero. So we're concerned about Q's. All right, so we're going to count, and we're going to start with the most significant digit and work our way down to the least. So we're going to have a 1, 1, 1, 0, which is going to be a divide by 14, which is going to count from 0 to 13. And you see this guy here is 1, 1, 1, 0. Here's our glitches, and we're going to reset at 13. Well, we're going to reset at 14 and then count to 13. Here we have a counter circuit, and we have a decoder. So let's figure out what the modulus in the count is. First thing we need is our NAND gate, and we're going to need a zero out. That's so that we could reset each one of our resets. So they all need to be connected. So the input to a NAND gate, unique conditions 1 1, OR gate is 0 0 1, and NAND gate is 1 1 0. Okay, so we need to figure out what's on the Q's, not necessarily what's on the Q naughts. Since this guy is a 0, this is going to be a 1. Since this is a 1, it's going to be a 1. Since this is a 1, this one is going to be a 0. And since this is the least significant digit, and this is the most significant digit, we need to reverse that number. Which is 8, 4, 2, 0 equals 14. So our modulus is 14 and our count is 0 to 13. And we come up with our modulus of 14 and our count from 0 to 13. We did well. Here they're asking us to design a divide by 7 counter. So first thing we need to do is put in a NAND gate. And let's put it way over here. And we're going to feed it back over there. So let's go ahead and change my pin color. Blue. Okay. So the first thing we're going to do is, let's go ahead and take this one up here, because 7 is 1, 1, 1. Okay. And here, we're going to need 1, 1, because that's our unique condition. So let's put in a NOR. Ugly NOR, but it's a NOR. Okay, so let's connect a OR like this. And that should be good. Okay, we have our divide by 7 counter, and we have a NAND and a NOR going through the zeros just like we have on our ugly diagram. So we did good.